Welcome back to our homestead. We have boys working on the sun porch, one on the ladder back there, and one working on the ceiling. We are going to put some of this beadboard up. We've got insulation partially done, and Andrew's working on the electrical. You can see the boys because I had it on blurred background a minute ago, and now you can actually see them. Andrew's putting ceiling fans up. Adam is measuring for the, I don't know if we call it lumber when it's like, you know, this beadboard and stuff. It's going to look different in just a little while. And then behind me, you can see the smoke from our little fire. I just want to make a note how quiet the boys are when I'm making a video, but usually they're not this quiet. Usually they're pretty chatty. Getting this beadboard up takes a little prep work, and so Adam is measuring, Andrew's still working on the wiring, and I'm just in general trying to be useful. Actually, at this very moment, I don't know where Andrew is. Perhaps he's MIA. Soon to return. As the boys are working on putting that wood up, I am starting this disaster of a living room. We've got to clean it out so that we can put wood up in there when they're done. And so it's going to be a long process, but I'm going to just go little by little and hope to get a little progress made. I'm afraid it's going to take a long time before you even are able to tell that I've done anything, but that's how it goes sometimes. Gracious, this is the kind of thing that overwhelms me. Meanwhile, the boys are still chugging away, but they are finding that this first board is very hard to get straight, and they have to get it right so that the other ones can go off of it and not be crooked. So they're having to take the first one down, run a line, and just do what they can to try to get this first run of boards straight, and then after that it will be smooth sailing, we hope. Just for fun, let's check on something. Many years ago, my mom and dad gave this little thing to Greg. Let's check and see how accurate it is today. According to this, we have clear liquid on the top. Let's hold it up where we can see it. And we have large flaky crystals. So according to this, large flaky crystals should be cloudy skies, snow in winter. So we either have clear liquid, fair weather, and let's check it outside and see how it compares. If you see behind me, there's not a cloud in the sky. It's perfectly blue. So the clear liquid on top gave us the right answer, and it is pretty cold. It's not stormy. We're not quite to winter yet, but we have the large flaky crystals. So I don't think we're going to get any snow because we don't have any clouds in the sky. I don't know how accurate that is, but it's just kind of fun to see how it changes. The forecast for our area matches what we see in the sky. 100% clear skies, sunny all the rest of the day. So those large flaky crystals on the bottom looked pretty, but may not be 100% accurate. We're just going to keep an eye on that. I just wanted to give an update on the battery situation. We had posted a video a week or two ago about our big batteries that we power by the solar, how one of them had gone out, and how we'd been in the process of talking with the representatives and so forth to get it back online. Well, we finally heard back from them, and this is just another odd thing I'm sharing with you because you don't always think about these things. Well, turns out the batteries are, so we are fully off grid, 100% off grid, except, you know, we occasionally will run a generator or whatever, but we are functioning off grid. Now we're still building and so forth, so I'm not saying we have everything perfect, we just are not on the grid. So the battery, okay, when the company sent our battery, the electrical components to fix the part that needs to be repaired, they sent the, and for the lack of a better term, I'm just gonna call it a motherboard. I don't really understand all the electronics of it, so it's a little control panel. Well, they sent that, Andrew hooked it up, and it still was in like a maintenance mode, and so then they conferred with China, which I also thought was strange that we're dependent on China. Anyway, that's a story for another day, but we had to call them back, and long story short, they said, okay, you need to get your Windows computer, you need to hook it up, and you need to do X, Y, Z. Well, okay. So this suddenly is making this off-grid battery system, you know, it's, we're solar, so we're dependent on the batteries and the solar, everything working. And suddenly we have to reset it with the computer. And I just think this is a little bit odd because, you know, if you want to be off-grid, yes, we do run electronics and everything, but as it happens, we do not have a computer. We haven't set up. We have one in storage that's very old, and I did have a laptop, but it has been retired a few years ago. So we might have to borrow a computer so that we can get our off-grid batteries back online. Isn't that the strangest thing you've ever heard? So I'm half a mind to just tell him, we'll send the components back to you. You reset it on your computer. Because what they said is when they sent it to us, they had forgotten to program it this certain way. And so we're not going to go buy a computer to reset our batteries. We will be getting a computer pretty soon. You know, I would like a computer, but it's just we have so many building projects expenses that is not on the plate right now. So anyway, you tell me in the comments if you think it's just funny that when you're off grid to get your batteries going back, you have to be on grid, kind of, right? You have to use power, you have to use electronics to power these things that you're depending on. And so what I'm thinking is, it seems like we are, yes, we're off grid, but sometimes it seems like we're off grid in name only, and we're still highly dependent on the everything, you know, the power grid and the electronics. So it is what it is. We got these batteries because they were so much better than the standard batteries that we had before. We had like a big battery bank of, I think they were like forklift batteries that we were operating from. And these four batteries replaced 12 or 16, and they've been very good, but wow, it's just so different, so different. So we still are down a battery until we, I think our son in town may have a computer, a Windows computer. And I mean, yeah, I would like to, I have it on my list of things to get when we have. To me right now, everything is dependent on let's get the house done. All of our expenses are going into the house, and so I don't want to buy extra things. Although they would make it nice, you know, doing editing videos and stuff on a computer would be way easier, I'm sure, than doing it on my phone. I do 100% of my recording, editing, everything, posting on my phone.
and it's working so far. You know, it is what it is. It is part of the off-grid thing that we do.
It's the end of the workday. It doesn't look like a huge amount was done, but they had to do so much fiddling with getting that straight. And now that they have, they're making progress. And you should remember that this is like a 32 foot stretch here. So it's not like it's just one length of a room. Anyway, we debated whether we would do the V-groove or the beadboard, and we decided for this ceiling to do the beadboard side. Now this wood has both. Here's the stack. It has the beadboard, which is this side, on one side, and then you can turn it over. I don't know if I can lift, I can't. You can turn it over, and then you'll get, when you put these two together, the two pieces, when you put the tongue and groove together, you'll get the V groove, which makes it basically a tongue and groove look with a V down the center. We plan to use a lot of this particular side, probably on the main ceilings of the cabin, but we do like the beadboard in some applications, and so we were kind of concerned if it would look too busy with the beadboard side showing. And personally, I like it. The boys weren't too sure, so that's why we tried it in here first before we do it in the main part of the cabin. But I personally don't think it looks bad. Just another look. So that's what we have so far. Tomorrow we'll just keep going with it. And then we have Andrew down the driveway doing a little grading, smoothing it out, because our driveway is more than a little bit rough. It's just one of those things we always have to maintain, the driveway. We have a pretty long driveway, but the steepness is what we notice. And then when we get a lot of rain in the year, it starts to make it a challenge. So I'm looking through the window, which has a reflection of this wood, so that is what is making those lines go across there. All things considered, we did end up getting a little bit more done on the ceiling. Pretty good progress for the day. Did I get the living room completely cleaned out? No, but I did make a good chunk, and it's looking more possible. So now that I've started, it's easier to keep going, which is a good thing. Considering where we were yesterday morning and now where we are this evening, I'd say we are making decent progress. It's just plugging away and doing the best we can. Thank you for sticking around to the end. Please consider subscribing, liking our video, and leaving us a comment. I hope you have a great day.